Good morning, good morning. I'm your host, Hassan Aline.
Co-host Carl Williams.
And we're in Apartheid, Michigan. Apartheid, Michigan. But we know it's apartheid. We got to pay extra taxes after water, extra everything. Taxes for the water, your home.
You name it.
They doing it to us. Well, you know, we want to start up there in Flint, apartheid Flint, Michigan. You know, we in Detroit, it's apartheid, Hamtramck, Highland Park, Benton Harbor, it don't matter. It's apartheid everywhere concerning black folks. And in Flint, they still talking about the water. Or should I say they not talking about the Flint water. The poisoning is going on in Flint with the mercury. The genocide is going on. And why we won't call it genocide, they're wiping out the whole 100,000 people up there.
That's exactly what it is.
Genocide. We refuse to call it what it is, genocide. You say, oh, it's not. What is it? What is it? They're not giving you any relief? They say, oh, we appropriated $160 million, $167 million, something like that, didn't it?
Yeah.
They don't come into effect until October. We keep telling you the process, how the process works. When they pass the bill this year, it doesn't take effect until next year. The budget bill for the state of Michigan doesn't take effect until October the 1st.
And they haven't fixed the problem yet. The pipes is the problem. You haven't heard them say it one time that they got, where they lied and said that they have shovels in the ground, but you ain't heard them talk about it no more. That's how you solve the problem, by fixing what caused the problem. Replace the pipes.
Well, they put about 30 pipes in the ground, huh?
And that's it, huh?
Out of 100,000 people. 100,000 people living in Flint. And then they say, well, we solved the problem. It's the water safe to drink as long as it has a filter. They're not telling you when you got to change the filter.
Well, that's contradictory in itself, because if you got to use the filter, that means that the water problem haven't been fixed.
That means there's something wrong with the water, right? You got to have a filter. Oh, I mean, come on. These, you know, the people down south ought to be aware of that. They had well water. Some people in Michigan got well water. And well water means if you throw that bucket down and you drop the bucket where it clouds up the water, you're in trouble. You got a screen. You have to take that water and pour it through a screen, because all of the, what they call the filaments or the dirt, the little muck and stuff at the bottom of the well, now has been pushed up and disturbed. So you got to pour the water through a screen, and then you got to let it set.
Yeah, sediment.
You got to let it, the sediments go to the bottom before you can drink it. So, wow. Poisonous Snyder. You know what? He's a good Nazi. He's a real good Nazi, isn't he? They still believe in that genocide philosophy. Get rid of the folks. Now, the way they doing it to the folks in Flint, ladies and gentlemen, they say, well, we're not going to put them in the poison gas chambers. We're just going to poison where they start acting crazy and the kids don't develop normally. And you say, well, what do you expect from them people in Flint? What do you expect from them colored folks and them Mexicans and those poor whites? Back in the day, they would have exterminated them. So it's a slow extermination process, ladies and gentlemen. It's a problem. What's the problem, Carl? We are looking for the people to do the same thing to us every time. Come at us the same way. They don't do that.
More sophisticated.
Well, black folks,
the same thing.
We're having a hard time.
Yeah.
Black folks are having a hard time understanding it's a warfare. It's a war on us. It's not a war on drugs. It's a war on black folks. Always have been. And because they don't have hoods on, they're not burning a cross in your yard, you think it's okay.
That makes it even worse.
but you're drinking poison water. But it's okay, huh?
Yeah, most of the time. Anytime, I mean, you look at TV, anytime somebody poisons somebody, that's a criminal offense. That's an attempt murder. And that's exactly what's happening in Flint. That is attempt murder. Because you can die from lead poisoning. That's why they call it poisoning. because it can kill you.
Doggone right it can. But it's okay. They don't care. I like that appellation for Governor Snyder, Poisoner Snyder. That's more to the point than Gangster Snyder. This man is more sophisticated than a gangster. He's a poisoner. He's out to get rid of hundreds of thousands of people, and nobody's paying any attention. They say, what happened to the Flint crisis? Oh, it's over.
No, it's not.
There's no problem in Flint.
Can you cut your water on? No. Well, it ain't over.
Well, you know, here's something for us to think about. It says here in this book, to his external credit, Dr. King, and this is Dr. Martin Luther King we're talking about, did not yield to the efforts of the FBI. However, for a time, the Bureau's dirty tricks caused deep distress of Dr. King, his family, and his associates. The FBI's attempt to destroy Dr. King is thoroughly documented in the Senate's investigation and in David Gorrow's book, The FBI and Martin Luther King Jr. Now, it goes down to say, let me see here, get to the point. The FBI under Hoover had unprecedented power. Unprecedented power and autonomy. Even so, the presidents and members of Congress in Hoover's time were mostly white men of narrow conservative views. Y'all didn't know they were white? You could count how many blacks were in Congress. And Garrow contends that the FBI faithfully represented these same American values and was not an out-of-control bureaucracy. Let me read that again, ladies and gentlemen. Says, granted, the FBI, under the FBI, Hoover, that's FBI Director J. Edgar Hoover, had unprecedented power and autonomy. Even so, the presidents and members of Congress in Hoover's time were mostly white men of narrow conservative views. And Garrow contends the FBI faithfully represented these same American values and was not an out-of-control bureaucracy. Garrow concludes that the FBI was not a renegade institution secretly operating outside the parameters of American values, but a virtually representative bureaucracy that loyally served to protect the established order against adversary challenges. So if you wanted to challenge the established order, white privilege, white supremacy, they stick the FBI on you. And we think right now the FBI is protecting the established order. You don't see the FBI investigating Snyder, do you?
Nope.
When are they going to FBI Governor Snyder, the poisoner, over that Flint water crisis? So it's established here that these people, the FBI, and the police agencies across America are not accidentally shooting black folks.
No accident.
They're not accidentally. If the FBI hounded, harassed, and went after Martin Luther King Jr., the nonviolent protester, they went after the Black Panther Party. They locked them up and wiped them out. All they didn't kill. They throw it in jail. This is the established order of things in America. What do you think is happening in Ferguson? When are we going to open our eyes? We got to go back and look. We got to go back and look at the ugly history in America if we want to see the truth. Then nobody say the truth was pretty, did they? Didn't nobody say the truth was going to make you happy. It said it's going to free your mind. I don't want to be free. If I got to know the truth, huh? Because I don't know. What is the because? Because you got to accept your responsibilities. You know, that's strange. You can go back to the days of Jesus since they get to talking about the truth will set you free or the truth will make you free. He told the disciples the truth when he said, oh, one of you among me is going to betray me. There's a traitor in the midst. there's a traitor in the midst. So we got to open our eyes, young blood, because old school is not telling you the truth. It has been the way all the time. This shoot, and I just don't understand where they get this crazy stuff from. I'm gonna protest at night. You out there at night getting shot or stabbed, and don't nobody know who did it. The cameras don't see anything. They say, oh, you're the looters. The black folks are the looters. Now they're so upset with the crime in America. The Republicans took over the White House. The Republicans got, you know, what was it? They had Dwight Eisenhower, who came in and became president because he was the successful general in the war. So he was on the Republican side. There hadn't been a Republican president in 20 years, whenever it was, 15, 20 years. FDR wasn't in there long. What was it, 3 terms? That's 12 years. So they had a run of 12 years. Then Truman filled out the rest of them. So what's that, 16 years? Now, what are we talking about? How did they get in? Through the riots across the country, the spread is fear. Fear across the American majority white folks, they fell for it. Black folks wasn't burning down their buildings. I mean, if you had free food, free clothes out there, they wouldn't got it. They called them looters. But they allowed that. They didn't have no big looting problem in Chicago. They call themselves getting out of hand in Chicago, Illinois. Mayor Daley said, these people are nothing but criminals. They're looters. And I'm giving the order. Called a news conference and said, I'm giving the order to the police commissioner. Shoot to kill. End of the so-called riot in Chicago. Mm-hmm. Simple as that. He came on national television. Held a press conference right there at City Hall in Chicago. And say, looters, it's a crime. These are nothing but criminals. Shoot to kill. End the story. And, oh, they got all kind of gangs in Chicago, the Blackstone Rangers, mm-hmm. the Disciples, the Latin Counts. You just name them. They got all kind of names of gangs in Chicago. Them gangs wouldn't sat down. So all this stuff that we see today is playing. And you say, oh, it ain't a conspiracy. That ain't what I just read in this book. Let me see what the title of it. And it got a picture of President Obama on the front of the book. It's some essays, American Politics and African American Quest for Universal Freedom by James Walton Jr. and Robert C. Smith. I haven't read through all of it, but it's pretty good reading, and it allows you to see the overall picture of what's going on here. And right now, today, it's reveille because people don't want to talk about the FBI. They don't want to talk about the law enforcement agencies in America and how they work with the Klan. They work with the Klan. The FBI didn't convict anybody. And there's a suspect in the killing of Lee Harvey Oswald, the person that assassinated President Kennedy. How do you let somebody in the jail walk up to you and kill your suspect, your chief man? But then again, the FBI was there, but they didn't have jurisdiction. You know, back then it wasn't a federal crime to kill a president. So that was local. Oh, yeah, they changed the law. But that was after the fact. Isn't that where we are?
Yeah.
All the time, a dollar short and after the fact. So you got the Flint water crisis that nobody wants to talk about. You got the same poison as the people in Flint that are running the show in Detroit. Now we're talking about the water. The same, water?
Same thing.
The water crisis in Detroit? They want you to pay a fee for the drainage? Same governor, the poisoner, the gangster that we have, Governor Snyder, here's governor. Well, that's who gave the order. And I've heard a lot of the discussion, and nobody wants to really put the finger on Mike Duggan. The mayor's the one that Gary Brown is working for. He's the city, he's headed at the city department. So that's, why they don't want to talk about that though, Youngblood? Why they don't want to call Mike Duggan's name? He's mayor. Why don't want to say, well, with the mayor, Mayor Mike Duggan?
He's over to the water department.
But Carl.
And he's appoint whoever, like Gary Brown, that's over the water department, so they're responsible.
But Carl, wasn't the preachers backing the right mayor? The right mayor, the white mayor, Mike Duggan? Isn't that what they said? We needed the right mayor?
That's what they said.
Huh? You know, it rhymes with white. That was a subliminal message they was giving us because they don't want us to call the man's name because they've been betrayed. They stabbed him in the back. Snyder and Duggan has stabbed these pastors in the back, and they don't want to say they've been tricked. They've been bamboozled.
No.
I don't know why they don't want to come clean. The man stabbed you in the back. But that's what snakes do.
That's right. And you should have knew better.
They should have. You can't serve two masters. I thought the preachers knew that.
Apparently they lost their way.
They lost their way, huh?
Apparently.
Yeah, trying to serve two masters.
Apparently.
So we need to talk about this fee again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna encapsulate it for you, ladies and gentlemen. They're talking about the parking lights. They're calling the parking lots impervious surface areas that where the water doesn't drain into the ground. It won't go into the ground. Like your lawn. The water on the lawn goes into the ground. And we know it goes into the ground because it run all them worms up. I ain't seen that many worms lately, have you?
Mm-mm.
What happened? What's in the rain that you don't see a lot of worms anymore?
That's something I thought about a couple of weeks ago, and then I don't fish anything, so, I don't think about it.
Don't really look for them. Mm-hmm. Well, me either, but I remember when I had to go out there and catch the worms for my father, the kid. When it rains, you can look for worms, but you don't even see the birds in the grass getting the worms.
Yeah, no.
You used to have to fight the birds off to get to the worms. So, anyway, I guess that's another story about what happened to the worms and the water. But the parking lot, behind the churches, alongside of the churches, the church parking lots that they want to charge this fantastic fee for, they have a drain in the parking lot. You see a manhole cover in the parking lot, that piece of iron out there. If you don't know what it is, they call it a manhole cover. And they're going to have some initials on it, DWSD. And we were over to, Friday before that. Was that Bethany Church? Is that the name of the church?
Bethany Church over there on off of 12.
No, the one on Chicago and Coyle.
Okay.
Reverend Bullock Senior's Church. We were over there talking to some people, and we had to tell them, say, look, think about it. Go out back there, look in the lot, and you got a drain. That drain cover, that cover, or what we call a manhole cover, is connected to your sewage line. You know, where the toilets and where the wastewater from the dishwasher, you're washing dishes, you're mopping the floor, you pour all that water into some toilet or other thing, whatever they got on there,
the sink,
all that water goes to the sewage, including the one in the parking lot. So what are they sending them a bill for? You already paying for the sewage. These criminals are charging the churches twice. They're charging them twice. That's a fact of life. They want you to pay twice, not twice the amount. You already paying a sewage fee that goes out to the sewer line. And that manhole cover is a line that goes from the manhole is the drain that allows the water from the parking lot to to go into the church's sewer line. So there's a sewer line out in back, and like in back of your house. We never think about it. So they're saying, oh, we got to charge you this extra money for your parking lot. They're already paying for it. You're already paying for it. So now you're paying twice, but you don't know that. And I hear some of the pastors saying, well, we wanted to know how you calculated these figures. We wanted to know how much per square feet. We just want you to give us a simple explanation on how you calculated these astronomical figures, this astronomical money that you want us to pay, that we can't afford. And they're sitting back there snickering at you, Reverend. And they're grinning with a straight, they're not grinning. They have a straight face, and they're saying, well, this is what we come up with, and we're going to get back with you. And they're lying because they're charging you for the same parking lot that you already paying for. So they're going to add it, and they're going to charge you now twice again? Wow.
Yep. You know, that's about everybody to get a bill. The sewage is already included in your water bill when you pay it. You got a top part that says water, and right up under there, it says sewage. That's the first thing. Now they want to come with another fee, and which is double, and call it sewage. Well, the Michigan Supreme Court has stated in 1998 that if it's a tax, that we are supposed to vote on it, and that if it's a fee, that it is voluntary. And that case is cited as Bolt versus the City of Lansing, 459 MICH, that's M-I-C-H, 152. For those who want to go look it up, you could put it in your computer and it'll come right up.
It'll come up on your cell phone.
On your cell phone. Anywhere where you got access to the internet, you can get this case. I'm going to say it again. That's Bolt, B-O-L-T, versus the City of Lansing.
Well, here's a good part that all the preachers ought to know, and they need to get this, they need to get the case, but we're going to encapsulate it for you and tell you what it says. A user's fee, this Supreme Court, this Michigan Supreme Court saying, a user's fee must serve a regulatory purpose rather than a revenue generating purpose. Well, we know it's revenue generating. They're telling you that.
They're
telling you that to your face. It's revenue generating. It says here, a fee must serve a regulatory purpose rather than a revenue raising purpose. A user fee must, number two, be proportionate to the necessary cost of the service. And number three, a user fee must be voluntary. Uh-oh.
Key word.
Voluntary. There's no more draft in the Army. If you want to go in, it's voluntary. Uncle Sam can't make you go in. So a voluntary fee is if you want to pay it, Reverend. If you want to pay it, Reverend, then pay the voluntary fee.
But we'll give you a copy of this if you want it.
Property owners must be able to refuse or limit their use of the commodity or service. The court found that the charge failed to establish the first and second criteria. Wow, there's no regulatory purpose. Collecting money, getting revenue enhancement, it's not allowed. That's a voluntary fee.
Yes.
Now, we can meet all we want. You can have all these meetings, but if you're not talking about the law, you're wasting your time.
That's right.
And somebody, you need to go get the reverends and the deacons, somebody need to go get the grandchildren. So they could explain it to them that if you're paying for this water right now in the parking lot, if it's going through this sewer here, how can they charge you twice? We're not talking about double. That's the wrong term. You're using the wrong word when you say double. No, you're being charged twice. And those fees are outrageous because they are more than double what they're paying for the sewage now.
That's right.
And the reason you're scratching your head is because you don't believe these people are that bold, that callous.
They are, because they know you don't know no better. They know you're not going to read, and whatever they tell you, you're just going to assume that they're right.
But the governor wouldn't do that to them.
Oh, no.
That's what they said.
Not Snyder?
That's what they said up in Flint. Remember the preachers came out, one of them came out and said, oh, no,
yeah. The
governor gave us some filters when he was denying he knew anything about it. And they forget about that. You know, well, when did you know about it? Oh, he said, I don't know what his problem is, but he gave us the filters. So certain preachers got filters when the rest of Flint didn't. So right now, certain preachers get preferential treatment. They can come to one of Snyder's affairs. You know, he can come back to the church members and say, well, I met with the governor the other day or last week, and we can talk to the governor, and we need to build bridges. But your bridge seems to be going to hell.
Seems like it's broke on one side.
Your bridge is going the wrong way. Look, the man didn't trick you. That ain't the first time we've been tricked. The whole point is we need to recover. And we need to be putting why are we putting all our faith in these people? This is warfare.
Yes, it is. There,
anytime you're being poisoned, that's chemical warfare. That's biological warfare. But you didn't think it was going to happen to you, right? You didn't think it was going to happen in America. You thought that stuff was only done where? With the Nazis? But these people are Nazis.
You just didn't know it.
You just didn't know it. They are the Nazi mentality. And they ought to give Snyder, since he's the great poisoner, the Fuhrer Award. They ought to give him one of them Hitler Awards somewhere. Oh, don't worry, they will. He goes back and forth to Germany. If, it ain't no if, they have a museum. I'm trying to think of the woman's name now. But the people that they claim, or the history says, plotted to assassinate President Abraham Lincoln, they have a museum down in South Carolina or somewhere around Washington, D.C. It's Maryland or somewhere. I'm going to have to look that up, try to figure it out off the top of my head. I don't know where the museum is, but I said I'm going to make it a point whenever I'm back in that state in the South to go to that museum. It's open Monday through Friday, maybe Saturdays. A museum? How does the people that plotted to kill and assassinate and kill our president of the United States, how are they afforded a museum?
They celebrating it.
Evidently. And they got to have some kind of secret underground museum for Kennedy, for the people that plotted against Kennedy, but that's supposed to be Oswald, right?
Right. Yeah.
We don't know, but if they did that for Abraham Lincoln, they're doing it for a whole lot of other folks. We don't know about it. And this museum is open to the public. And I've never heard of it. It's crazy. This is a crazy, crazy world that we live in, that we think these people are on our side and they okay, and let's give them a chance to do what? Poison our people some more? And the poor young blood that's protesting, the Black Lives Matter folks, they out there and don't know they need to protest in the day and not light at night, and they're calling them looters. I saw the folks on television about 11:30. CNN, 11:30. About 11:30 at night. You know, I was watching it, and Some just say cut on the television before you go to bed, watching the CNN, and they Don Lemons, and they show white folks kicking in the windows, kicking the glass, breaking the glass. And they showed that, and they hurry up and got that camera off of them white folks. And they didn't say nothing about these white folks were looting. Mm-mm. Only blacks. See, that's the lie they tell, and the black folks don't have sense enough to march in the daytime. Martin Luther King Jr., SCLC, they march in the day. The march on Washington was in the day. The march right here in Detroit with Martin Luther King.
I just want to know who come up and what with that brilliant idea to march at night. I mean, that don't even make no sense.
Well, that's they want to help the Republicans get in. They want to help Donald Trump say he's the president for law and order. Now you know what they're talking about. They're talking about the civil unrest that they're blaming the black folks for. You know, these police officers get a commission. They get money for killing black folks. Oh, Hassan, there you go again. Now, we know they don't get any money. How come? Didn't Wilson, what's his name, Darren Wilson,
yeah.
Didn't he get a GoFundMe account? Didn't the man get over $500,000?
Yeah.
Oh, well, that was for legal fees.
Still with money.
Legal fees. They said he was not guilty. So, you can keep that money. They keep that money.
He don't give it back, that for sure.
Somebody sent you $10, $20, $25. And they're getting paid to kill your silly behind. And you want to be out there at night protesting. When the innocent brother got killed, your protest is to stop spending your money with him. Oh, I can't do that. I got to go play the lottery. Well, I can't do
ain't
that.
Never hit, but still want to play.
No, don't hit.
I seen a young guy. I started to say something, but I didn't. He in there scraping the last penny, trying to play the lottery. Most of the time when the lottery falls, it don't never fall in Detroit, so why are we playing? Don't make no sense.
Well, they get the $41. They hit for
$41. Oh, yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
But look how much he done played just to get that $41.
Oh, yeah, a dollar a day. He paid $365 and ain't hit but once a year, once every 3 years.
If he
got that.
So that don't even make no sense.
But and we want to say this other thing before we start taking the calls, to hear what the callers got to say. Dan Gilbert is pushing for, I think they call it a brownfield, but he wants something like a tax increment district where his property, the land and property that he owns, don't have to pay any property taxes. That means Detroit, your property taxes are going to go up. Detroiters are already paying for the police and the fire and the garbage pickup in the city of Detroit. Downtown property owners don't pay for that. We've been telling you that for years.
Yes.
I can't help it if you don't believe it, didn't believe it, just coming around to believing it. Most of you still don't understand it. Why you don't understand it? You don't want to understand it. You don't want to believe the white folks don't pay any property taxes downtown.
And you haven't heard nobody come here and challenge us and say we was wrong?
Well, hey, it's all in the newspaper. It's all in the newspaper. They turn around and says, get yesterday's free press. They talking about it in there. Yesterday's free press, front page and the back page of Section 8. 8A is the end of the article. They are talking about, the business is really going to come. Is it going to really invigorate the city of Detroit? Well, see, the white folks slow to catch on. As long as they doing us in, it's okay. Mm-hmm. The man says in the article, well, are they going to just raid the suburbs and bring the business out from the suburb downtown? Wow. Gee whiz, SARS. The man sound like Goldman Sachs. He just catching on. They put it in the newspaper. You know, the white folks is upset with Dan Gilbert, the billionaire, who got he's the puppet for Warren Buffett. and Jamie Dimon, chairman of Chase Manhattan Bank. What is he, second largest bank in America? $2 or $3 trillion assets. That's how he's buying up Detroit. I know y'all think he's some whale of a businessman. And you better think twice about it. So how are you going to lower your property taxes? Your property taxes are going up through the roof, through the sky. Your property how do you lower your property taxes? You get on these council people, get ready to recall your council people for voting this junk in. They got to change the legislation in Lansing, and then these yo-yos on the city council, the alcoholics and the crackheads we have on the city council. Oh, that's right. They're not crackheads. They're marijuana smokers. They got their legal marijuana card. They're going to vote for it. That's what's going to send your taxes up through the roof. And the fact that we're not aware that's how the game is played.
You need to get on them, councilman, now.
Well, let's take some calls. Thanks for holding, caller. Caller, you on the air. Hello, caller. Caller, you on the air. You've been holding a while. Okay, we'll go to the next one. Caller, you on the air. Hello, caller.
What's happening?
The wave. That we are being attacked. And one was with the gas chambers, one was with the water flooding in Flint. Well, you know, I think that in Detroit, as well as the rest of the country, the minds of our young people are under attack. And it's through the music and the movies, videotapes, and they're negative and encouraging our young people to participate in all kinds of illegal things, such as the drugs. And I think I shared with you once, there are the lyrics from one song that says, give her X, meaning ecstasy, and she'll sex everybody in the building. There's another one about killing people. And those kinds of videos give our young people who really have not learned any social skills yet, I guess I'm supposed to do this, you know, and next thing you know, they're out and about doing whatever they think they're big enough to do according to the songs that they're listening to. So that's something for adults to be mindful of, and parents in particular. And if they just could stand it, to turn on one of those stations for about 5 or 10 minutes and listen to the lyrics of some of the songs and know that our children are hearing these just over and over and over again. That's a brainwashing technique, you know. Right. And for every 25 times that a person hears it in our community, it's only heard once out in the white community, interestingly enough. So I just wanted to let people know to listen if they can stand it. And also beware of folks who pull up beside you with the music so loud that it rattles your car, and if there are any children in that car, they're hurting the children's eardrums. So, and don't forget to tell folks to register to vote by October the 6th so that they can vote, and we want to get Judge Deborah Thomas on the Supreme Court.
And absolutely. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
They also started sending out
absentee ballots. Yeah, so look for your absentee ballots. We got one. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey.
Go right
ahead. Hey, how you doing today?
All right.
Listen, there's so much going on today, you know, that I know a lot of, you know, I was listening to that Highland Park program and the mayor was on, and I asked him, does he employ residency there? And he said, no, our officers are allowed to work 15 miles out of the city limit. And I'm like, just going, are you out of your mind? You're going to let the white officers take the paycheck that the black people that paid them out to Rochester Hills? And I'm looking at this guy like, you've got to be a clone or something because you ain't black. I mean, and then another thing, when white folks have scientific specifically and systematically remove the black man, woman, and child's integrity, black people will do anything for money. I mean, they will sell their mama. They see, we are white people's mother and father. They are disobedient children. And the children are running the parents now. See, so what we're going to have to do to solve all of this is we're going to have to separate. We're going to have to do what we were instructed by the universal consciousness, which is to be ye separate. He said, when I send you to this land, do not join the people in the land. We're going to have to come together like that and just move to one state or something to separate from these people. I don't know what to do. Thank you for taking my call.
Thank you for making it here. Carla, you on the air?
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
You know, when you talked about Flint, they're pausing and carrying out genocide. And all the things you said they're doing, you all are right. Now, here's what I found, and when you talked about the Black Lives Matter walking at night, they are still light years ahead of Detroiters. Now, why they're light years ahead of Detroiters? Yeah, I agree, they should march in the daytime. But why in Detroiters, all you hear is people talking about fighting the government. That's who our enemy is. A lot of people say they. It's the government, the federal government, state government, and our local government. That means the city council and them and the mayor. Those are the people who is playing the same role that the government in Germany played. Was Hitler was a government. There was a government. So when I hear the fighting in Detroit, I hear going to court. That's not no fight, because it ain't hurt nobody. A fight, when you're fighting, you're hurting. Some opponent hurt you, you hurt the opponent. I hear them talking about going and electing somebody. That ain't fighting. The only way you fight, everything we ever won, it was not going to the institutions of the government. It was outside the government. There was mass marching in the 30s. That's how we got Social Security, that forced the government to give Social Security, unemployment compensation, and welfare for single mothers who didn't have a job and had children. In the 60s, it was mass marching, not boycott. I hear people talking about boycott. They didn't even count how many people it is and how much money they got. So I know they're joking when they say boycott. Boycott only been successful one time, and that was in Montgomery, a little small town. Boycott is not the way you got a whole lot of unemployment people. You can't boycott because they ain't got no money. So but I looked at the 60s. I seen them marching. 800 cities, there was demonstrations in 1963. That forced them to pass the 64 Civil Rights Bill and the Food Stamp Act. And then in 65, I seen a mass marching across the bridge, Bloody Sunday. And I seen the voters' rights law pass, and with that, Medicare and Medicaid. The only way we have won anything, it was through mass marching that would hurt their businesses. They couldn't produce, they couldn't sell stuff because all the people was in the street. That was billions of dollars. And that forced Johnson and the government to pass those things. Other than that, we have never won nothing in rioting. We've never won nothing in boycotting. Because you can't boycott with unemployed people when you got 84% of the population in Detroit don't have a job. That's 16 to 65 for poor. So when I hear people say boycott, I know they're joking. They're not real. They're just speaking off the top of their head. They haven't studied nothing. So let the people in Flint come to Detroit and in big cars, and we join them. Shut down the billions of dollars of development and all going downtown, and force say if we don't have this, you cannot develop, and we'll hurt the economy. Unless that's done, all else going to courts, going on the bus.
Okay, Tyrone, we got to go. We got some more calls. We got to go. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. You know, ladies and gentlemen, it's one thing I believe in is more than one approach. Now, some people have a, I call it a pet peeve, they only have one approach.
Vision.
Now,
tunnel vision.
Tyrone talks about the mass demonstration. When they were in the South and they were standing around Woolworths and the lunch counters and they were demonstrating, but people also called that a boycott. They were picking in the places and they did, and people wouldn't go in. They didn't want to cross the picket line. They didn't want to push on them. They didn't want to push people pushing on them. So they chose not to go in, and he's right. They lost money. And that's what happens with a boycott. A boycott isn't as visual. You know, it isn't as sexy as somebody picking in. Yes, there should be mass interruption of trade in the city of Detroit. They should be. But how many people want to do it? They did it one time, and they still patting themselves on the back when they slowed the traffic, when they stopped traffic on I-75 for a few minutes.
They're not doing anything now. Anybody could talk, but put that talk into practice and
get
the people together.
Good morning. How are you?
Yeah, like you said, you have to try all approaches. We do need hundreds of thousands of people to boycott while you're boycotting. If you're marching in the daylight, you're shutting down businesses and commerce for those who care nothing about you. Because the cartel, criminal elite, population control, and history repeats. And I've always said that the Hitlers and the Jim Crows and the Klans never went anywhere. They just recruited some more. So, yeah, we have to try more than one thing. And don't forget to vote for Judge Thomas. And I'm voting for, what's his name, at-large counsel, David Bullock.
Okay. David Bullock.
Okay, before
Okay, take care.
Before we get any further,
thank you.
I wanted to let the viewers know out there that I have compiled a damage fee objection and protest. You can object to those fees, which we have been talking about, and included in this, we cite the case. So you can get a copy of this. We'll be at Burger King right there on Davidson around about 10:30, between 10:30
and
11.
Get it at the station. You're gonna leave
and I'm going to leave a couple up here at the station. So you can get a copy of this.
160 Victor.
Yeah, 160 Victor, the damage fee objection and protest.
And do you say in here somewhere that they no longer want the voluntary services?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm asking you. I didn't get a chance to read it.
Well, here it is. In 1968, the Michigan Supreme Court ruled that the storm fees and virtually all properties in the city of Lansing to pay for the city storm water and sanitation sewer separation project cost as permitted under the state was unconstitutional and in violation of the Headley Amendment in 1963, the Michigan State Constitution, Article 9, Section 25 and 31. The court also held that a user fee must be a voluntary property owner, must be able to refuse or limit their use of the commodity or service. And I cite the case Boat versus the City of Lansing, 459 Mich 152.
So this is something that they can mail in to Gary Brown, the director, that's what his name, let's see, Detroit Water and Sewage Department Director Gary Brown, Deputy Director, what is this? Mobley. Palencia Mobley.
Mobley. I was wondering. Deputy Director.
All right, let's take, we got some more calls here. We're down on time. Carla, go ahead.
Good morning.
Good morning.
You know, I want to congratulate the powers that be because they left no stone unturned when it came to going under every rock of the city of Detroit to suck the money out. Now, who would have thought that they would have gone after the churches? But this is what happens when we don't stick together. When they came after the schools, I didn't hear anything from the preachers. When they came from the retirees, I didn't hear anything from the preachers. In fact, one preacher said it was a good deal. Wendell Anthony. Oh, that's a good deal. It's a good deal.
That's right. Yeah, you're right.
Now, they're after you. I mean, what's wrong with them? Don't they know that once they pick off, they're picking us off one by one? The churches, who are the so-called staple of the city, they're getting ready to decimate them because there's no way in the world you can afford to pay $9,000 and $10,000 a month on a parcel for some doggone drainage. So what they're doing is running these churches out of business, which in turn will leave vacant some more vacant land for them to come swoop up for pennies on the dollar. So, you know, it's sad. But why do we sit up here and we haven't learned a white man yet? We've been around him for 400 years. We ain't learned his tactics yet. They divide and conquer. It's the old divide and conquer, and we have fallen for it. And I feel sorry for the churches, but hey, they were nowhere around. They got their little 503C, tax exempt, blah, blah, blah. Now they're going to have to pay for drainage on their parcels,
but
as well as any of those charter schools that they opened.
Right, but call
They were glad that some of the public schools went out of business so they could get some charter schools. Now they got to pay for that and their church parcels.
Right.
So, it's just a shame.
Caller,
but, hey,
caller,
we've been tricked again.
You've been listening. Caller, you've been listening. The whole thing in this is that's what they're telling the preachers. The preachers are coming back and telling us the same thing, but that's not what the law is saying.
Okay,
and they,
I understand that.
Are charging them twice, and the water is going through their same drain.
Well,
that's the killing part. It's almost like saying, once you point it out, how dumb can your person be?
Exactly.
How dumb can a person be? The water is going through the parking lot drain. It's going through the sewer. The same sewer line that they flush the toilets in. They're already paying for it.
But my point is this. When the citizens was going through the same thing, when they charged us all extra money, we didn't hear from the preachers.
You're right. You're right.
I know it's illegal. I know that.
But we need to tell them that.
It's the same for us as it is them. But we didn't hear anything from them. This is my point. All this mess is illegal. But we didn't hear anything from the preachers. But now it's on them. Now that they've been...
Well, we got to go. There's the music.
Okay, bye-bye.
Hey, we got to go. This is the fastest hour anywhere in television. I'm your host, Tarsana Lean.
Your host, Kyle Wade.
And we'll be back next Tuesday. And you can get some of these forms up here. Yep. Or like you said, we'll be at the Burger King on Davidson, but not all day. Peace.